Hey guys, it's your Overtake certified expert on Assetto Corsa Competizione, Jared here, coming to you with another tutorial. A car has to be more than just fast or easy to handle. The balance of everything is the most important to make you fast. In order to achieve that, you will need to tweak your car of choice to fit your needs. Today I will show you how I handle setups and how you can build some of your own Assetto Corsa Competizione setups without any help. I just would like to add, this is a very simple but really working setting. If you want to build a setup, the first you need to know where to start. 99% of my setups, they start from the aggressive default base in Assetto Corsa Competizione. And that's where we will start today as well. Like I said in our previous tutorial about tips how to get faster in Assetto Corsa Competizione, the car track combination is very important. We link the video down below if you want to take a look. But don't go there yet. Stay until the end of the video to get the big surprise. Today, I felt like setting up the Aston Martin for the Hungaroring racetrack. This is a good combination because the track offers a lot of low speed corners and the curbs that Aston really likes. The aggressive preset provides a lot of good options to be on pace with other drivers. I would say if you execute everything flawlessly, the aggressive preset can be within a second of the customized setups, even maybe faster, depends on the situation. So if you are looking for good orientation, the standard setup is already quite good, but sometimes you might look for something else to get different results. I would advise any new drivers to evaluate their driving style first. I know it might be odd to you, but this is only achieved by driving on a certain track with a certain car. Only that way you can find what you need and the car needs. If you also want to learn what you need from us, make sure to subscribe and hit that bell button so you don't miss any notification of this awesome content for Assetto Corsa Competizione. So let's start to practice and evaluate. I started to do some time attack on Hungaroring. It was a little cold with 22 degrees Celsius, so I lowered the amount of the brake ducts to 3 and 2 to avoid my brakes being cold for too long and also to get some little bit more temperature in my tires. If you close the brake ducts, less cold air will reach the brakes and therefore the tires. That's why they will get up to the temperature more easily. The more laps you do, you will notice which problems are related to the circuit and which are based on your setup. After that, you carefully start to adjust options in the setup menu. I felt that when I noticed the massive understeer I had in the fast corners, that was especially apparent in the mid on the last sector of the Hungaroring. So I wanted to start and change that first. When you start adjusting your setup, make sure to work with the simpler things first. For example, height of the car. Some of these options have bigger or smaller impact depending on how you drive. I'm usually more conservative, so I started by adjusting the rear height. The reason for that is that the high speed corners require more aerodynamic grip from the car than lower speed corners. This can be achieved by making the car higher, which I did by around 12 millimeters, which is a lot. There are upsides and downsides for this. If you put your wing too high, you will press the car down to the ground, therefore creating more understeer. But if you overdo this, your car will be all over the place. That's why I'm trying to work with the height of the car as well, because it will give you more balance and more thing to work around. This is why testing is so important, so you know where you went too far. The Aston Martin is a car that's easy to control, and that's why it's not that much of a problem to change it up a little. You won't immediately get the oversteer of doom. I also lowered the ABS from 4 to 3 and changed the brake bias all the way back to 61% to make the car more rotate and easier to use on the brakes. I did this because the understeer will most likely be there because of the Aston Martin is so heavy on the front. It has a long nose and focuses lots of its power in the front wheels. Increasing the movement of the car in the back can help countersteer the stiffness that the safe style of the Aston Martin creates. These small fixes already helped me so much in the fast corners in the Hungaroring, because I didn't have to worry about too much of the understeer and the car was quite stable as well. After I solved the initial problems, I fixed on the tire pressures, which is the thing you should usually start with, but I wanted to get rid of the bigger problems first. The right side of the car was fine, but the left side needed a bit more work. I increased the rear left by 5 and the front left by 3 clicks. Something that is very important for you to know is the OMI, readings of the tires. That means outside, middle and inside temperatures. It gives the racer in-depth way to check how the tires are doing. This tool can help you massively in identifying when your tires are not getting the right treatment. A good check is the following. If the difference between the inside temperature and the outside temperature of the tire is around 5-6 degrees or less, then you are still fine. I had a cooler inside, so I increased the camber by 1 click, which tilts the tires more towards the inside and thus gets more temperature in the inner body of the tire. With the tires, you always want to stay between 27.5-27.7 of PSI. PSI basically makes the measurement of the pressure of the tires in this game. Obviously, it depends on your driving style, on the track conditions and your setup as well, so you might do some fiddling with the numbers and with the clicks up and down to get your correct pressure. I usually do around 3 laps to see how the pressures are actually behaving in the same conditions. Lastly, I wanted to try something more specific for you guys, so I tried something new. I noticed my grip was getting a little less in the lower speed corners, so I played around with the mechanical setup. I noticed the understeer on the last few meters of the corner exit, so I added 3 more clicks on the bump stop wrench on the front suspension. I also lowered the rear suspension stiffness by 1 click. These are still basic changes. Stuff like dampeners are way more advanced and you need the telemetry data for that. All these options are part of the mechanical grip, which is the opposite of the aerodynamic grip I fixed earlier. Suspension, bump stop wrench, anti-roll bars and the camber, for example, are there to make your life in the lower speed corners easier. As expected, especially the chicane was much easier to handle for me. The adjustments made easier to carry speed through and keep grip. Definitely the right change made here. With these small changes with the Aston Martin, I went from 143.5 to 142.6 and the car felt way better than before. As you build experience, building your setup will get easier and more natural the more you drive and the more you practice. It is almost as important as evaluating your own driving style if you prefer oversteer, understeer or more balanced setup. Beginners often lack knowledge or how to set up the tires. So if you run into the problems, it could be because you run with the tires that are overpressurized or underpressurized. Setups in Assetto Corsa Competizione are a core component and if you want to understand them, you will have to build them. Unfortunately, there's no shortcut that automatically presents you with all the knowledge to forge the perfect setup. No matter what, building your own setup is a long journey, but on the end, you always will get more reward. You will get faster, you will get more confident, and you will probably even crash less. If you want to try my really basic but kinda decent setup for Aston Martin and Hungaroring, check the link below the video in the description. For more esports content in general, make sure to check overtake.gg or make sure to subscribe to the channel, make sure to leave a like and have that notification box on. And I hope to guys see you in the next tutorial.